Welcome into the latest in our series, Knicks, Stars and Lockdown. Great to get the chance today to chat to Alex Rufer. Roof, you're looking good. You've got the holiday beard going on there, mate. I know we're on a bit of a break, but you need to stand a bit closer to that razor.
Yeah, I sure do. I've made a little challenge for myself to keep it going until the end of lockdown, and then once we're out and about, I'll definitely shave it off because I'll be a bit embarrassed walking around with this thing on.
Tell us about your bubble. I mean, where are you and who's in there with you?
So I'm in Palmerston North with my mum, and I've just been here since we got back from Sydney. And yeah, it's just me and her. It's quite quiet here, and I enjoy it though, so it's good.
So what are you doing? I mean, well, firstly, around football, no doubt you've been given some sort of training program to follow by the strength and conditioning team. How are you staying fit and kicking the ball around?
So I go for runs most days. Palmerston North's quite small, so I can I seem to get around quite easy. But I've got a local park about 100 metres away, so I just walk down there and do some fitness training. I do some shuttles and stuff like that. So it's been quite easy. Sometimes it's obviously quite tough when you're alone, but it's kind of just, it's self-motivation, So, yeah, I'm enjoying it. It's something new. I'm just trying to, take it day by day and just trying to embrace it, I guess.
And what about the other stuff, Roof? I mean, you can only run and train, for certain periods in the day. How are you filling in the rest of your time?
Well, we've got a few sessions a week on Zoom now with the team, and so we've been doing some Tabatas and stuff like that, which is quite fun. So that kind of gets a little gym blowout and get your heart rate up a bit. So that's quite enjoyable as well.
What about staying in touch with some of the guys in the team? Are you still? I mean, while you're not face to face with them and having one of those famous coffees that you guys enjoy so much, you're staying in touch on WhatsApp and things like that?
Yeah, for sure. Speak to a lot of the boys on a daily basis. There's been some good communication, and I think that's really important, obviously, to make sure everyone's all good and you're just checking up on people. So, yeah, no, it's been all good.
Tell us a bit about your season because, you started off brilliantly as you finished last season, then that injury at Eden Park. Can you tell us a bit more about that and what the recovery from it consisted of?
So, yeah, when it first happened, obviously, in Auckland, I didn't think it was too serious because it wasn't too painful and things like that, but I was struggling to walk, and obviously that's not a good sign when you do something. And I had a grade 2, quite a bad grade 2 MCL tear, and so just basically I just had to rest it for a while once we found that out, and then just slowly build back up running and change of direction, strength and balance work and stuff like that. So it was about 2 months, and obviously it was a bit longer than what we expected, but I've had obviously a bad injury before, and I just wanted to make sure that I did the recovery well. And I didn't really want to put too much pressure on, rushing back, because I know that if you don't do it well, you can set yourself back for longer. So, yeah, look, I mean, injuries happen, and obviously they never come at a good time. But I think as well, it's sometimes good to sit on the sideline and sit on the sideline and kind of reflect, and also it's quite motivating to get back into the team.
And as far as that's concerned, obviously while you were away, Cammy Devlin took his chance, and he and Matty Steinman teamed up in midfield. Then you came back, and then of course 3-2 doesn't go. How challenging did you find that, sort of battling away with those two for a place in central midfield?
Well, it's always nice to have a challenge, ever since I first arrived at the Phoenix, there's always been really, really healthy competition. And I think the biggest difference is that this season we've obviously, we've really put Phoenix on the map. Last season we had a really good season too, but this season, I think we were very good. And having a team like we did is, it's always tough to, once you're out of the starting 11, to get back in. But look, full raps to the boys, not only those two, but everyone. We had a really good season, and just really proud to be a Phoenix player.
Yeah, and when you were coming off the bench, you were making an impact. I think about the game against Central Coast. You came off, you provided a very quick free kick for Josh Soterio to score. Does it change your mindset at all, Alex, when you know that, hey, I'm not going to be there from the first whistle, but I could be on at any time, and when I get on, I need to make an impact?
Yeah, look, I think I obviously go into every game with the same mentality, to give my best and to help the team as best as possible. But yeah, look, sometimes being on the bench is you can look at how the opposition are playing, and you look at some weaknesses, and as everyone, as Josh said in the interview, we actually did come up with a little plan for that. So that was quite cool. But look, I just look at it like it's another opportunity to learn, you know. So it's just that's the way I look at it. And obviously, I'd want to be starting and playing 90 minutes, but that wasn't to be. But I still give my best. And we had a great season, so hopefully we can get back to it.
Absolutely. And what about as far as the All Whites are concerned? Because you were part of the last All Whites camp that went away for those two games. Obviously, everything's on hold there as well. Has Danny Hay been in touch with the playing group with any messages or any update from a national team point of view?
Yeah, he has. He sent out a video on the previous tour just to keep us, thinking about the style of play there. And look, it's a shame because we would have had another international trip, which obviously isn't to be. But I think again, that's another thing to really look forward to. And when all of this settles down, love playing for the national team, and I really can't wait to get back into it again.
What about fishing? Because your Instagram, you look like a professional fisherman rather than a professional footballer. Are you missing the fishing?
Yeah, look, fishing is actually it's a big part of my life. As you said, I love it. I've just been brought up around fishing my whole life. And in Palmerston North, there's a river here, so I haven't been fishing yet. But if I'm here in Palmerston North in a few months' time, when we can go out, I'll definitely start fishing again. And yeah, some of the boys said while we were away, look, if we struggle for food, we can just get Rufa to go fishing. So a few of them were happy that I was there. So that's good.
Where do you fish in Wellington?
Oh look, I have a few spots.
I don't want you to give away your secrets, but
I was about to say there's spot X. No, I fish a lot around just off the rocks and things like that, in Evans Bay and just around everywhere. I try new spots. I've got a few. I've got friends that own a fishing shop in Wellington, Steve's Fishing Shop, and they're awesome. They give me a lot of gear, so I'm really thankful for that. And I'm lucky enough to sometimes go out on a boat with them, so that's a true blessing. I love going out on the boat. So yeah, no, it's awesome.
Well, anything else you're particularly missing, Ruth? Obviously not seeing the boys as one and not playing, being a professional sportsman. We've talked about the fishing. Anything else you're particularly missing?
Oh, I think the big one for us is just the routine, Like for me personally, I love having a routine of getting up, going to training and things like that. But yeah, it's been hard to kind of get over that. But now that we're well into this lockdown, I think I've tried to make my own sort of routine at home here. And my mum's got me sanding and painting, which has been a new experience. So but I've loved it as well. So it's been awesome. So just to help around the house and no, it's been good just to also have a bit of time to relax too, because it was quite stressful being in Australia not knowing what was going on. But now that that's all settled and now we're in lockdown, hopefully we can kick this virus to the curb and then get back into it.
Good stuff. I've got one final hypothetical question for you, and it's around the international players in the Phoenix squad and the five-a-side team that they might make up. So if you think about the English guys, Ball, Taylor, Hooper, add in Davila and Steinman, and
Yes.
think of that as a five-a-side team.
Yeah.
You're the captain of the other team.
Okay.
So what four Aussies and Kiwis are you taking with you into that five-a-side team to challenge the flashy imports?
Okay. So we'll go Ollie Sale in goal because purely because he has brilliant not to say Steph doesn't have brilliant technique with his feet, but Ollie is like having another central midfielder with the ball, so that's I want to play out from the back. I'll have Kakache as well. He's an animal. He can get forward and back. I'll have one defender. I'll have myself. I'll go with Sam Sutton, and I'll go for Josh Soteria and Reno Piscopo.
Wow. Okay. So you've picked a goalkeeper and five outfield. I'll allow it. I'll give them Marinovic to have in goal for them. That's a good side. Actually, just on Sutton, he might be. That's a surprising pick. He's a good kid, though, eh?
Yeah, I really like Sam. He's a good kid. He works hard. He's a dog, and I really like his attitude. After most trainings, which is quite impressive, he's always running and doing extras. So I think he's one to really look forward to coming into the first team in the future. And he's a weapon of a left foot, so he's an exciting player, and hopefully he can break into the first team.
Good stuff. Hey, it's great to chat. Sorry to drag you away from your sanding and your painting. Your mum will be knocking on the door before we know it, but it's great to see you in such good heart, Roof. And let's hope that you and the rest of the Phoenix boys are back out doing what you do best real soon.
No, awesome. Thanks, Bonnie.